Did they already start? No, they haven't started yet. All right, so we're at the Grand Lisboa Palace today, and I just found out yesterday that they were gonna open. I think it's gonna be a relatively minor opening, but because it's a Friday, and so they probably didn't want to be overwhelmed with people. You can see here they have the I can't get over there. They have the lion ceremony happening here. You can see the lions here. This must be the executive group getting together to take a picture. I don't think it's actually open yet, so this is kind of exciting because we haven't had an opening of a casino in a fairly long time. Even the Londoner was a refurbishment. This should be. It'll be interesting to go through the main doors, for sure. Well, it looks like we might be able to go inside now. They already checked my QR code, so we're just gonna attempt to go in with everybody else. Take my camera into the casino, so I'm not really 100% sure what's happening. I guess I just need to try and look like I belong. All right, this appears to be the east lobby here. Wow, completely decorated in this marble here. This artwork's pretty nice. I think this is the front desk. There doesn't appear to be anybody here. It's a very interesting picture. It looks to be primarily landmarks of Macau and also some Portuguese. You can see them down there. That's kind of funny. Oh, it's just covered in artwork. As we saw in the original Lisboa, there's the, you know, historical. Hey, what's going on? Why do I hear the lion dance? Are they gonna make their way through here? I don't wanna miss it. Trying to get a little bit away because As you notice, the lion dance is super loud. And as I've mentioned in many of my other videos, part of the purpose of the lion dance is to scare away the evil spirits, right? To scare them away. That's the whole purpose of the lion and the color red and the very loud drums and cymbals. So, you know, it's gonna make its way throughout the entire property. I was thinking it'd be a good idea to follow it, but it's gonna be too loud for you guys to even hear what I'm saying. So, we're gonna try to make our way back to where we were. Let's go. Oh, all right, so we were here in the East Lobby. And we were taking a look at the artwork, right? Sorry for the detour. We were checking out all this interesting artwork that they have here. All right. Wow, just the massive amount of marble that they have. Look at all this. All right, this is a little empty at the moment. Doesn't seem to be a lot happening here. I want to go through the middle one. Okay, another reception area. Oh, I like the artwork here. They took like a, these are like the cobblestones that you see in the Sonado Square and the star, you know. There's a lot of like Portuguese references, right? Chinese, Portuguese, I mean, that is what sort of the essence of Macau. Coming soon. I don't expect everything to be fully open yet. They did sort of plan this on the middle of a day on a Friday, so I'm assuming they were trying to keep the crowds a little bit low, give a chance to the teams that are running the casino to you know, fully prepared. Grand Lisboa Palace GLP Cafe. Okay. All right, we're in. This must be another entrance. So I've noticed that the trend with building these casinos here in Macau has been you put your casino right in the middle of the property, and then you effectively build around it. So you build restaurants and retail and all sorts of other things around the casino so that people have various points of access, but also for those people that can't go through the casino, they have a way of being able to move throughout the property. This isn't like Las Vegas where, like, I remember when I was younger, you could walk through the casino, and as long as you didn't loiter or stick around in the casino, you could just keep moving. But here it's very strict policy, and now with, you know, everything that's going on, it's even stricter to get into the casino. So we're just gonna keep making our way around the casino, and I want to show you guys what's going on. Now this is the ground level, so at this point I don't see too much. I've seen a couple I've seen one restaurant on the ground floor. What is this? Eight Treasures. Looks like another restaurant. Oh, this looks like Grand Lisboa Palace West Lobby. Okay, here's the gift shop here. All right. This looks like a lobby, like a bar slash lobby. Interesting. Oh, they do have people at the reception desk here. So that's a little bit interesting. Okay, hello. And then they got a whole nother entrance with the chandeliers. Hello. And then you got the flowers here that you had before. Here is the, and then you got the greeter at the door. Oh, that's very nice. I'm still in shock by the amount of marble that is going on here. It's just like overwhelming amount of marble. All right, let's see where this takes us. Gaming. Gaming. We're obviously not going inside the casino. All right, look at that. All right, I see more people. Just gonna work. Oh, that's cool. Let me see if I can give you guys a shot of that. Oh, they got all these like... Ah, this is an interesting lobby. And they got all these like... I don't know what you call these. They look like those decorative eggs. You know. Oh, and from here I can't really keep going, can I? Do I need to go up these escalators at this point, or can I keep walking around the ground floor? Huh. Interesting. Well, we're gonna try to see if we can. Nope, that's definitely locked. All right, so for whatever reason, we can't go in there. So we're gonna go up the escalators. Oh, you can't go up the escalators. It's completely closed. All right, so it looks like there's a whole section of the casino that is closed off for whatever reason. Maybe there's still construction happening there. That's part of the reason that they, you know, they had this sort of soft opening here. So that's interesting. Why don't we go up to the next floor and work our way back and see what else we can see? I was thinking when I was walking through this lobby with all the marble, the ground is like black and white. So I kind of feel like a chess piece moving through it. All right, so we're back on the second floor where we left off the lions last time. So we're gonna make our way through here. See if there's anything special going on up here. One of the things, it is quite bright, very white. A lot of the decoration is very white. Very interesting, the way they laid this out. Oh, what's going on here? This looks like, obviously Chinese or some sort of Chinese restaurant. Not open yet. All right. Keep it moving. Oh, this is closed off. All right, so this looks like where all the retail is gonna go. But it's closed off at the moment. Closed off at the moment. All right, there was another way we could go. We could go on the other direction and we could see what was going on over there. And then that might be it for the Lisboa. I mean, can't take you guys in the casino. So this might be everything I have to be able to show you guys for today. Let's find our way over there. Again, it was really impromptu. I found out about it yesterday. And I wasn't even sure if I was gonna come out and make a video. So I figured it'd be nice to give everyone sort of a first look. Maybe after it's been open for a while, I can come back and see everything that they've added to it. But at the moment, this looks like it's gonna be everything that's going on. Okay, so that looks like it's open. Now I saw something interesting on this other side. It was named the Carl Lagerfeld, and I'm not sure what that means. I don't know. I mean, it sounds like a person's name, obviously, but I don't know who that person is. I'm sure if you know, please leave me a comment down in the section below, and we'll figure it out. The Carl Lagerfeld, and it's got all these like little symbols. I see sunglasses and. I'm not sure what those are. A chair? I'm not sure what this is. Oh. Alright, this area. Oh, okay. Here's what it is. But it's still unclear to me. Maybe it's closed. Yeah, it's closed. It's a little unclear to me what it is. No, it's not the spa. I'm pretty sure it's not the spa. No, it's not. I saw a
All right, let's keep going over here. What is this? That's interesting. All right. All right, looks like it's closed over here also. Oh, is this open? All right, we're getting a little bit of a... Is it a part of the hotel? Is that what it is? I'm not sure. Let's see where these, let's see where this elevator goes. We may not even be able to take it without the key, so I'm not sure. This is like very contrasty. It's very dark in here, as opposed to the rest of the casino that is very, very, very bright. So, so it's interesting. So they see they're going for this sort of contrast. Very, very nice. Elevator is not very fast, or it's busy. I'm not sure. All right, so where does this take us? Can I take it to the top floor? No, I can't.
No. Open back up.
Gaming, shopping. No, you can't really take it to any of... Oh, wait, I can take it to the third floor. All right, at this point, I'm trying all the buttons. What's the third floor? Oh, it wasn't clearly labeled. This is interesting. It's like a bar. This is a bar area. Okay, spa, gym, swimming pools, restaurants. So I'm just kind of discovering this place as I go along. Oh, that's cool. Looks like there's another restaurant over here. Oh, are we getting close to this? Oh, is this like a gallery? This Carl thing that, you know, maybe, oh, here we go, Lagerfeld. So I don't know, maybe he's an artist or something, I'm not sure. I'm gonna have to do some research when I get home. Let's see if it's open or closed. Yeah, closed. Looks interesting. I'd be super curious. This is one of the more curious things because I see like books and pictures and color and it sort of grabs my attention. Here we go, Carl Lagerfeld, here. All right, everyone, so just a little bit of backstory. I came out to Macau in July of 2015 to open up Wynn Palace. Now, Wynn Palace opened in August of 2016, and the Grand Lisboa Palace was supposed to open about the same time. Now, if I remember correctly, there was like a construction fire, and then there were delays and delays. And anyways, I was a little bit worried that I was never gonna get a chance to see it and show you guys. So we're sitting here now in July of 2021, finally getting a chance to see the Grand Lisboa Palace. I am super stoked. Come on, let me go show you the rest of it. Let's keep moving here. Okay, here's what I was saying. So here's the contrast, right? Here's the contrast as opposed to the ground floor that was completely white. We're now on, this is the third floor, and you can see the ground is black marble. The, you know, part of the wall is, it looks like a door. What is that? That's pretty cool. Ooh. Is that a bathroom? This is so cool. It feels very like Inception wise. I feel like I'm moving through this space. There's nobody around. I'm the only one here. You got these, I'm not sure. Oh, they're made out of metal. All right, let's see if this is open. Oh, it's closed. Wow. All right, guys. Well, since I'm the only one here, this is where I'm gonna leave you. It was an interesting first look. I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I did. And yeah, I guess I really don't have much else to say. I'm gonna go do a little bit more exploring on my own. If I find anything interesting, I will add it to the end of this video. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.